I'll go ahead and get our city council meeting called to order. We do have agendas on the podium in the back here if you'd like to grab one and follow along. It's nice to see all these smiling faces this afternoon. Tonight is our regular council meeting. As you know, on the first Monday of the month, we have our workshop, and that's where most of the discussion takes place. So the items that we'll be discussing tonight and voting on are items that have already been discussed in that first Monday meeting and workshop meeting. So we have reviewed everything, and we'll be ready to have maybe a little bit more discussion and then our voting. At this time, I'd like to introduce Pastor Todd Garner with Union Grove Church of God. Pastor Garner is going to be here to make a little presentation in just a few minutes. But Pastor Garner, if you don't mind, I'd like for you to open us in prayer, if you would, please.
Heavenly Father, we love you and thank you for this day and for your many blessings, God. We pray, Lord Jesus, that you bless this meeting, God. Bless our city. Bless our nation, God. You've been so good to us this far, God. And we just pray that your hand of protection and provision be upon our city, our state, our county, and every part of who we are and what we're doing. God, I pray, Lord Jesus, that you bless the mayor and the city council, God, and all the members of this team. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you. And I'd like to call on one of our firefighters, Ms. Samantha Diaz, is going to lead us in our pledge. I do want to make one order change, though. We have Ariel Godwin, who is going to be talking with us about the comp plan. He is actually number 19 under new business. I'd like to move him up to just after public comments, if you don't mind. He also is going to be making a presentation to the Tie Council meeting, and so we want to make sure that he has time to address this council and then get to Tie for that meeting. So that being said, I'll take a motion to that effect.
So moved.
All right, thank you. Is there a second?
A second.
Any discussion? All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Thank you. Also in our packet, we have the minutes from our last couple of meetings. We can take those collectively. We have May the 7th, and then we have our special call meeting, which was held on May the 21st. No, I'm sorry. That was our regular meeting. And then our special call meeting. Those minutes are all in our packet. If anyone has any changes to make, or if you'd like to make a motion, I'll accept that now.
I move we accept them as is.
Okay. Any other? Is there a second?
Second.
Any further discussion? All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Okay, thank you. The next item on our agenda is our public comments, and again, I've invited Pastor Todd Garner with Union Grove Church of God to come and talk to us about a program that his church is putting together called Serve Day. So, Pastor Garner, I'll give you the floor and let you share that information with us.
Mayor Smith, thank you for the opportunity and City Council. We are in a process of something called, and you'll see it in front of you there, something called Serve Day. And it's a time that we're going to take one time of year to be able to serve our community with a project. Our vision is a vision of healing, hope, and health to bring to our Tifton city and also our surrounding communities. Our mission is to fulfill this vision so that one, people can know God, find freedom, discover their purpose, and make a difference. We believe and we understand this Serve Day is an opportunity to each part or a segment of our community to make a huge difference in there. And we have five projects that we're working on right now. These five projects you'll see mentioned here. The first one, we're gonna team up with the Pregnancy Care Center here in town. We're gonna serve, we're gonna clean rooms, we're gonna do whatever it takes to make that better with that part of our community. And then we're going to our senior adults ministering in our nursing homes. With our students, we're going to be able to give them some care packages, different things that they're going to do during that time. Then also, our third project is working with our foster care system to make sure that each student or child in that system has a nice book bag, some other things that are there, And so we're excited about what's going to happen there. The fourth project is something we call H3, and H3 means Healing Hope and Help. We have been blessed by a local businessman here in town that gave us 15 acres as a church, and we're going to make our all of our outreach ministry in that area. And so that's on Union and Golden Road, and we're going to develop that. Hopefully we'll have a park out there one day, hopefully a lot of other things that will be out there. And partnering with the local churches there, we are already serving with the YMCA and other organizations for after-school programs, for Food for Thought programs, different programs that we're doing right now. So this is very important to us, and we're just in the beginning stages of that, and we're looking forward to being able to really make an impact in housing and different things that we're going to do there with our H3 project. And then the fifth one, talking with Mayor Smith and making sure that we did that, we wanted to make ourselves available to you and say, where's the biggest area of need in our community right now? Is there a block? Is there a place? Is there a park? Is there a community that needs us to pick up trash, change? Maybe you know somebody that needs wheelchair access. Anything that we can do, that's how we're going to serve in that capacity. So these projects, July the 14th of this year, we are setting this day aside as our church. And when we came here 7 years ago, we had about 100 people. We have about 700 people that call UGC their church now. And we want to not just be a church, we want to be active out in the community and what we're doing. So this is what Serve Day is all about. And that's what our H3 Center is all about. So as we go through that process, that's going to be very important for us as we go forward, that we want to, anybody that we can work with, help in any way, that's what we want to do. So that's what this is all about, Serve Day.
Thank you. I wanted all the council to hear the same information that I received the day that we spoke on the phone, because these gentlemen know the districts better than anybody. And so if there are any neighbors in your district or areas or projects that you could use some help with, or have a neighbor, you know, maybe someone's elderly or doesn't have the wherewithal to take care of some things at their property, this would be, it would be a great time to be able to witness to them and to help them as well. So I just wanted to share that with each of you. Would it be okay then if they just called you with,
yes,
with locations or ideas?
Put a card up there and you get in touch with us.
Thank you. Thank you for what you do. That's a great thing to do for Tifton. So thank you for that, and we really appreciate that. That's what makes this community great. It's everybody willing to help each other and look out for our neighbors, and we appreciate very much what your church does, and thank you for your service.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right. The next item on our agenda is we do have public comments, and we do have three people that have signed in. Mario Lamont, did you want to address the council? Did you just sign in? Did you have anything you wanted just sign in? Okay. And then Hayward, you're signed in. You didn't have anything particular. Okay. All right.
May I address you from here, and I'll
sure.
Step back to the picture.
Yeah, that's fine.
I'm Hayward Fowler. I live at 108. I live at 115 East 2nd Street. I don't get my home address, but I'm in media. We have strange pictures on there. But I live in Tilton, okay? I'm sorry. My question for you guys is this. We did a story on potholes, but we did that story premature because y'all didn't have the money to fix it. When you got the money to fix it, you fixed it. Okay? And we weren't good at slamming anybody, because y'all work hard for us, and we know that. But here's what we would like to have, because we're changing the way that we do things. Mm-hmm. We're no longer going to play loop play. We're going to be more like a real television station. And this is going to happen in about 30 days. And we want to do a real good local news, a real good positive local news, where we show what's going on in town and cover some things that's happening. The Gazette does a wonderful job. We just thought we would just kind of finish up some things, and all of us just covered everything. Eve does just a magnificent job. But this is just something that we're adding. Now, here's my question, okay? I said a 1,000-word session on this. I wish y'all had a news person that could be available if we want to do some follow-up questions on some things that y'all are doing. Mm-hmm. Now, Pete is always handy and he's nice, but he stays incredibly busy.
Right.
And
want people to be informed. You know, we have, I'll just take this opportunity, if you don't mind, to share with everyone. You know, all of our meetings are on YouTube, unedited. We try to make ourselves as available and transparent as possible.
Sure.
So having Morgan there to fill in that role, I think, would be very good to kind of close the gap and finish the story or at least, you know, share with you what's going on and that kind of thing. So.
Well, sometimes I get some Facebook posts out of you guys, and they're wonderful too. But sometimes the media needs to ask a question.
Sure.
And this way, we can broaden it a little bit, and we may ask something that you guys don't cover, or we may want a little more in depth and want to hear interviews or whatever. And I know that y'all are very open to that. So I just need for them to contact us or work with us through email or telephone call or whatever.
Okay.
And if we have some questions, we need a designated person we can go to and say, we have a question or whatever. Now,
okay.
In the past, we've done it through Freedom of Information, which is a dumb thing to have to do. I mean,
you just call.
That's
all you need to do.
Just
that's call.
All we need to do. But again, we all work on that.
Absolutely.
And we have somebody report to us.
Absolutely.
And that way, Eve and I both can show up at the same time, and she's willing to, and we can both ask some questions. She's out working us right now.
Morgan's not here right now, is she?
Yes,
oh, there she is. Okay, I can see you're behind the pole. Okay.
Yeah.
Morgan Atwater is our public relations person, and Morgan will be more than happy to get with you on that.
I bet.
So,
she's very intelligent.
She's doing
yes,
a great job. So, yes. Okay.
So, okay, that's all I got.
Okay, perfect. All right.
Thank you.
Okay, you're welcome. The next person that has signed in is our own Lynn Levitt. Ms. Levitt? The Georgia Power Company and Ruth's Cottage and Patty Cake House and about a dozen other things.
Yes, I will be, but just a minute. I'm here on behalf of Ruth's Cottage and Patty Cake House. Last week, I was present at the county commission meeting where you had delivered the service delivery agreement paper signature that was needed for our grant to be considered. And I was able to thank that group for all the work they did, and I really just wanted to come and thank you. You know, it was sort of, as you said, Mayor, the perfect storm, in that with the transitional housing needing to be added, and the 10-year service delivery agreement needing to be updated, and all of that came down to a few weeks, and if not agreed upon, our grant could not be considered. And so we just want to say thank you.
Well, thank you.
On behalf of the whole board, I told them all, Pete, yours and Jim's work and all the hours. People cannot imagine the hours and the conversations that went into it. I know we met with several of y'all individually, and I know you talked to DCA numerous times, and we just thank you so much.
Well, it is. I'm very thankful too, and thank you for Ruth's Cottage and Patty Cake House and the service that you provide. And it's an incredibly important project for this community and our region, not just Tiff County, but our region. So I'm very thankful that everything has worked out, and we did get an email from the Department of Community Affairs within a day or two after that county meeting, indicating that they had received everything. Everything looked to be in order. So I think we're good at this point. And the other part of this, I think, for us as a council, with regard to the service delivery, is I think it brought awareness to us that we need to be communicating with our friends at the county more than every 10 years on service delivery. So we've sort of talked amongst ourselves and have made a commitment to have a little more communication regarding that and not just wait on those state mandates. So it was a good lesson learned, I think, for all of us. But thank you for what you do and for the project. And well, just let us know when the ribbon cutting is. We'll be ready.
Well, I think it speaks highly for all of our leadership.
Does,
I mean, this leadership that we have in the city and the county and at Ruth's Cottage is going to be the one that makes this shelter happen.
Absolutely.
And that's just an exciting thing for our whole community.
Well, I told you, when you made the comment that you were out stepping out on a leap of faith, we could not leave that unanswered. So there's a lot of faith in that, and I appreciate that. So
thank y'all.
Thank you. Any other comments or questions for you? Okay. All right. Is there anyone else you'd like to address the council? Is there anyone else who would like to address the council? Okay. How about you? Come on up here. He's not signed in, but we'll let him talk.
I'm just fashionably late, you know. No, I just want to kind of tell you some of the things that we're doing. On July the 7th, which is the after 4th of July. Fortunately, it comes in on Wednesday this year. So, but on the 7th, we're going to be putting in our gateway, I'm building it's a portable stage that we're going to be able to use for that. Not only that, but we'll be able to fold this thing up, take it inside in the restaurant, and we'll hopefully have more and more of these, plus the public, anybody that wants to get married out there, anyone that wants to put on some type of play or anything of that nature. We'll charge them a small fee to set the thing up. I've got lighting, all of that for the stage up there. We'll be having, I'll put cool fans, misting fans out there that'll keep the temperature down during the summertime. And so we're looking for a big time out there, and we're looking to do not just, this is the first of what we hope is many. We'll have a concert out there. I've got some friends of mine that are in an old band of Stillwater in Macon, Georgia, and also Doc Holliday. So they formed a group, and they're going to be coming down, and we'll have it's a free concert. Doesn't cost you anything out there, and we'll be serving food and alcohol or whatever in the park, drinks in the park out there. So it's free. You can come and go as you please. The only thing you can't do is if you're going to have alcohol, you cannot leave that gateway. Cannot leave the restaurant without calling your hands. Other than that, we're looking to have a big time, and I just wanted to tell you, those are some things we're trying to do to draw more and more people downtown to.
That sounds like fun. That's exciting. That's very good. Well, we appreciate what you're doing with 41 in Maine and Hawkeyes, and everything going good at Hawkeyes.
Everything's great.
Perfect.
It's awesome. Awesome.
That's
awesome.
Great. Well, thank you, Hal. We appreciate
Thanks
that.
Thanks a lot.
Okay. Fun stuff happening around Tifton. At this point, we'll call on Ariel Godwin. He's going to present us some information with the Tifton-Tipton County Comprehensive Plan. This is actually item number 19 on our new business, so we're going to go out of order for just a second, and then we'll get back on the order of the agenda.
Thanks. Good evening. As most of you know, the comp plan gets updated every 5 years, and this is the final step in the update process. It's a joint comprehensive plan with Tifton, Tifton County, Omega, and Tai-Tai. It was drafted through a series of 7 workshop sessions and recently approved by DCA, and the final step is for the community to adopt it. There should be an item available for you that is a resolution to adopt the comprehensive plan. It says very simply that the city of Tifton adopts the plan, and that my only items are to address any final questions and to request action on adopting the plan. Are there any questions about the plan?
That resolution is on page 109 of our packet. Does anyone have any questions? I know Pete's participated in all of those.
Meetings.
Some of us have kind of come and gone at various meetings. So
once the plan is together, obviously we'll give that to you, part of our annual report this particular year. Very comprehensive. We did make some smart changes, but the community was involved in this, and there's a lot of good input, so we'll have that prepared for you as soon as the full document.
Now, will we need to, can we go ahead and approve the plan update now, or do we need to wait until we get the actual plan?
No, this is what it is for resolutions to last then.
I do have drafted it, too, if anyone wants.
All right. That being said, if anyone would like to make a motion to go ahead and approve this plan, I'll take that now.
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you. Further discussion.
Mayor Council, I do want to thank those that were involved, but most importantly, the Regional Commission. Ariel, thank you for the help. They've guided us through this in 7 meetings. It was like pulling teeth at some hours there when we talked about certain things, but they did a great job with city and counties and county with things that we had needed update, and then keeping us on track. So it was a great process.
Okay. All right, so we have a motion and a second. Any further discussion or comment? We will add our thank you to these thank yous. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? All right, done. Thank you. And look, you can just almost walk to Tai-Tai.
Thank
you. Got so much
time. I appreciate that.
Take your car. All right, we are back on schedule with the agenda. The next item is our consent agenda. And again, these are all items that we've discussed in the workshop. These are items 2 through 14. We can take these individually, or if you'd like, I can accept a motion to approve the consent agenda as a whole. Is there anything that we need to take separately?
Yeah, I want to take number 7 separately.
Okay.
I want to take number 9.
Okay.
11.
Okay. Do you want to make a motion approving everything other than items 7, 9, and 11?
I will.
Okay.
So moved.
So moved. All right. Can we have a second?
Second.
Okay. Any further discussion? All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? All right, Jack, you want to go back and just start with number 7, the resolution approving the municipal court judge service agreement.
Yeah. What did, you know, we had discussion about what it was going to pay, whether it's going to include benefits, and I couldn't understand why we're providing all these benefits for somebody should be a contract employee.
That was taken out, and once Chad and I talked about the last ordeal, but the benefits, the annual salary is there where I put from last time, and then any professional memberships will be limited to the training for the judge duties. So all that will be taken out.
So he will be treated as a contract employee?
That's
right. Does that mean he pays his own Social Security?
That's right.
As well?
Like to make a motion, or would someone like to make a motion to approve item number 7?
So moved.
All right, we have a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Thank you. All right, do you want to take item number 9?
9 and 11 I'd like to table.
Table. All right, and that's the ordinance
that, basically
that
the
would
ones,
be rezoning from
yeah,
the
that's the Waffle House piece and the Harvey, that whole little shopping center of Harvey's. I'm just not ready to
make that change. Okay. All right. So you want to make a motion to table. Does that need to be to date specific?
Yes.
It does. This has gone through P&Z. Okay. Danny has specifics, so we table it to next meeting. Obviously.
I just realized. Rob, I should have. Rob,
go ahead, Rob. We could hear you.
Yeah. Just if you want to postpone that, you know, it's really a motion to postpone to a certain date
okay.
rather than tabling it. So just postpone it to a date certain.
Do we have to have a date, or can we just postpone it indefinitely?
Well, you can either postpone it to a date certain, or you can postpone it indefinitely.
Okay, I want to postpone it indefinitely.
Okay, so we have a motion.
That'd be fine. Just,
what was that?
Did you say something else, Rob?
Yeah, I just gonna if you want to postpone it indefinitely, just make a motion to postpone indefinitely.
Okay, that's okay.
And then.
Okay, so we have a motion to postpone those two agenda items indefinitely. Is there a second?
Second.
Okay. Any further discussion?
I'd like to ask why.
I'm not comfortable at this point changing something to change it from neighborhood commercial to general business. Now I realize right now the business is there okay, but that doesn't mean 5 years from now they tear it all down and build something that would allow a general business distinction would allow that versus a neighborhood commercial.
You just can't.
So I don't want to. If they did that 5 years ago, we said okay, they tore it down and said we want to build X. Then we would decide at that point, is that something we would want close to this neighborhood? It's across the street from these apartments. It's other housing and stuff. So I just don't see a need to set ourselves up for a bad problem we could have. Why do that?
And have you, I mean, the neighborhood, the people in the neighborhood, the residents there?
Well, we already went through this whole business with the hospital building, their building, and we couldn't stop that. But the neighborhood were incensed that the hospital could build this, what they put there, and we can't stop that. We can stop
this.
Other businesses if they don't fit the neighborhood.
My understanding is what the city staff is asking for this.
Danny, do you want to just kind of remind everybody about that?
P&Z has heard it, and then staff recommendation is this. We're just trying to making the zoning more consistent with the property across the street, number one. And number two, the general business gives us a little more boundary-wise if something was built to work with versus neighborhood commercial. So it's just for consistency purposes and making that whole corridor the same type of zone.
Which which I think makes sense.
Well, the problem is, I mean, to be, what goes across on 41 has nothing to do with what's there at Harvey's in those houses that are half a block down or those apartments. To make it consistent with what's next to it, which was Affinity. And I didn't look back in the records, but I guarantee you they only changed the zoning from neighborhood commercial to general business when Affinity wanted to be built. Okay, and they made the decision then, okay, let's change it, this is what's gonna be here, knowing that what's behind it is that buffer. And then lo and behold, the hospital decides they wanna build something back there, we, like I said, we couldn't stop. So to say it's consistent, well, no, consistency is it's neighborhood commercial. They changed one of them to general business, so now you're gonna change it all to general business? I don't see it, not for that neighborhood.
Any other questions, comments, Danny? Any input regarding any conversation at P&Z? I know we talked about the workshop, but
all the items that Pete discussed are absolutely correct. It also helps us conform to that comprehensive plan that we just
adopted. Okay.
It's more in line with it.
Right. Okay.
That's the only reason I recommend it.
Okay.
The zone for neighborhood commercial versus general business. What's the big difference between the two?
There are setbacks.
Can we come on up, please?
There are setback requirements for the buildings. General business are typically smaller. You can build buildings higher. Neighborhood commercial requires more permeable area and less concrete. And there are only certain types of business, and they are typically professional type buildings. And general business, though, has more of a, they're more restrictive on the landscaping. They require larger buffers, and they also require different infrastructure, sidewalks, water, those kinds of things.
So what is occupying that location right now? They would be able to do that in neighborhood commercial. It's like if there was another spot somewhere else, it was neighborhood commercial, would the Harveys or whatever, would it be able to go there?
Grocery stores are allowed, yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
But if there was any kind of out parcel development, that would fall under the general business or fall under the neighborhood commercial?
There may be things that want to be in that strip center that may not be allowed.
Okay.
It would be restrictive.
Okay.
Can you give any examples of what would be restrictive? I guess that's what
I can't. I can't off the top of my head. The comprehensive plan says that's an interchange, and so that's our main corridor, I-75, Highway 82, US 319. Those are our main corridors for people traveling coming through Tifton, and so that was the idea, was to develop that and grow those as tourist attractions, accommodations, those sorts of things.
I'll tell you what, for next meeting, for next work session, what we could do is just put a comparison between GB and neighborhood commercials, so you can see the difference, and then the parcels that align that, I think it'd be easier, so you could tell what is currently, and then, you know, like Councilman Folk said, if in the future, if something happens, what's going to be most restrictive? What we're trying to do, especially in the comp plan, make things most consistent along those corridors. And we could line those up side by side for you and let you look at that, if that would help.
I'd rather do that than postpone it.
I have a little issue with the indefinite part.
That just gives us leeway. If we want to bring it up next time, we bring it up next time instead of setting the date. But, you know, that next, we talk about Harvey's, and they just renewed their lease, or if you look at Facebook and it says that's what they did. But next to it are those other ones, which half of which are empty. I mean, we need to be able to control what goes in there. I mean, I've got houses a block over and apartments next to it, and it's just, we're opening ourselves up for trouble.
All right, well, we have a motion to post, and a motion and a second to postpone indefinitely. So I'm going to call for the vote on that motion that's on.
Can we amend his motion? No? Okay, so apparently it's not easy to do, so we'll go ahead.
Okay, all right, so we'll call for the vote. All those in favor of postponing indefinitely, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Nay.
Nay.
Okay, so the majority vote is to not postpone indefinitely.
Right. Okay.
So
I move to postpone until the next meeting and give staff time to show comparisons.
Can we amend this? Y'all just turn that down, I suppose.
No, I think it was the indefinite part. It's put a date.
Yeah.
Even if it needs to be the August.
Because I want to hear the difference between what can and what can't go.
I'll agree with it. Let's go with the August.
Okay.
Okay.
So,
to amend it to August. Rob, you hear?
We can bring it up and discuss it all, but we may not vote on it.
At least we can discuss it.
Rob, you
hear?
No, I did not.
Okay.
I understand they did not postpone indefinitely.
Postpone until the August workshop for discussion.
Okay, so we have a motion. Did somebody second that? Did we get a second?
I'll second that.
Okay, so we have a motion second to postpone the discussion of this change for items number 9 and 11 until the August workshop.
Right. Okay.
Okay. Any further discussion? All right, I'll call for the vote. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? All right.
Okay. That's for 9 and 11, right?
That's for 9 and 11. That's correct.
Okay.
That is correct. All right. Did we approve the rest of the consent agenda?
Yep.
We did. Okay. All right. The next category is our resolutions. Item number 15 is a resolution providing for the new alcohol license for El Limon located at 501 South Ridge Avenue.
Mayor Council, at your station there, there was an email from Danny, and like I said last meeting, there was some concerns. This is just for you to acknowledge, if you so choose. And these are the most pressing things that we have heard from the community, and what we're hearing in and around with regards to this business. So, if you want to make this as a condition, or you want to mention it, that is for your information.
Did you see that, Johnny?
But
I know,
yes.
You were concerned about that.
Yeah. About the trash in the park and the parking. Did we ever get sufficient parking there?
Yes.
We did? Okay. Now there's some more stuff here.
Mm-hmm.
Parking on others' property. The people at the automotive shop right there, and the people at Tyson were concerned about this.
Right.
About parking on their property. And if you park on their properties after they leave, and the trash is, you know, like the garbage stuff, they're concerned about that. Now, I can understand that. Because if you use my parking after my store closed, you need to clean it up before you leave.
Yep.
You need to be responsible for cleaning the property, cleaning my property, and the security of my property after I leave. If you're going to use it for parking, you're going to have to use it. If you with the kind of people you're talking about coming into to this place, these two properties on the side.
But wouldn't that be, that's private property. They wouldn't be able to without permission, I would assume. Is that?
Yeah.
You think so?
Well, Do you think so?
Yeah.
Can you tow the car?
Well, if the property, if they want to, then okay. Let's put a tow sign up. That any, we did that down on Tiff Avenue down there. People were parking, going to the bar, but they were parking in the Georgia Department of Labor parking lot. Okay, they brought that to the council about that. So what we had to do was if they parked there, have them towed. Because they were running to the same problem. People were going over there at night, using their parking, and there's trash in the place and not cleaning it up. And then the person that owned the bar said he wasn't responsible for it. And he's right, he wasn't. But
I mean, I guess they could put a chain across there.
Well, if they want to, they could, or they could speak with Mr. Elmore and make sure that if they park on their property, that you are going to be responsible for cleaning it up. Now, if you tell me that, then I vote for that. I mean, what I'm saying, if you, but no, wait. I want you to tell me. I want you to tell me that if any of these things have here on these properties, that you're going to be responsible. Can you be responsible? Can you tell me that?
Well, let me explain you something. We got 32 parking spaces that we've been working on that. And we got 18 is in the back gate. Everything's been closed. And then we got 12 in the front, I think, I can remember. But everything is marked.
Okay.
So, now, if we find out that one of the customers going to neighbors or something in Paris, we got to make sure we clean that.
Okay.
So, I mean, we are responsible people.
Okay.
We are also here.
That's all I want to hear you say. You're responsible.
So, one of the things that concerns the people had is the somebody break in the other property. We got cameras.
Yeah.
And we will have security. So we will try to do everything the legal way that we can do it, you know, the best way we can do it. We want to try and be
being good neighbors. Okay.
Now, we got another neighbor on the other side that we had a problem in the beginning, but after we start talking, you know, he parked in our parking spaces. We don't have no problem.
Okay.
You know, we got an agreement, so they can park over there. We don't have no problem in the daytime or whatever. As long as we don't use the parking space, it's fine.
Okay.
So we as neighbors, I mean.
Okay.
We don't need to be in it.
That's all I wanted to hear. Thank you, sir.
You good?
I'm good.
Okay.
All right.
So we'll, if so desired, I will take a motion if y'all would like to go ahead and approve this resolution for his alcohol license.
So moved.
So we have a motion and we have a second. Any further discussion? All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Thank you. Our next resolution is providing for a new alcohol license for Joe Petra, Incorporated, doing business as Jay's Food Mart, located at 10 Sandra Drive. And we did discuss that at the workshop as well. Is there a motion to approve that license?
So moved.
All right, is there a second?
Second.
Any further discussion? All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Thank you. The next resolution is for the amended alcohol license for the local kitchen and bar located at 212 South Main Street. And we also discussed that at the workshop.
That was actually a new one.
Okay.
But they're only adding catering.
Right, okay.
So that's
all.
So
they currently have a license, it's just
yes.
to upgrade, so to speak, to the catering.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
So moved.
All right, we have motions or second?
Second.
Any further discussion? All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? The next item is a resolution for approving the FY19 budget, and we do have a copy of that budget at our place. Is there any, Pete, is there any update or any information we need to be aware of?
I will, before I go into just a recap, there was two items that were still pending. Some of you wanted to make sure at your station there's a description about the SROs. And I did talk to Patrick Atwater today, and the Board of Ed did confirm that they will be paying 100% of the five SROs for 180 calendar days to the city of Tipton. So,
an SRO is school resource officer.
That's correct. So we are stable as far as that's concerned. I told you there was some concern about the line item on the general fund budget. If they did not approve that, we would have to do some changes to the budget. But that is secure and that is in place. So if there's any other questions, I left you a spreadsheet on the costs. Chief and I could answer any questions that you may have.
Okay.
The second was the library. And I also did a recap of the library and the budget. Obviously, we don't have any involvement in that, but there was some questions about the hours. And just quickly, the amount that we have for the library budget, $138,715. There is a $5,000 amount that was committed to last year, making it $143,715. The library hours, you can see just as a recap, if the library director wants to take those down, there's some specifics regarding that. And then obviously my recommendation would be to work closely with the branch manager this coming year to review the details of the operational concerns and the potential budget needs, simultaneously working with the county to see if we could level off some of the funding needs. And I do not know exactly what that would be given the climate. So that would my recommendation to you.
So, I mean, do we have any money that we potentially, you know, additional funding? I mean, this ain't having to cut back hours for the library. It's just, I mean, I don't like it. I mean, there's people that can't go anywhere else. They don't have access to the internet. They, you know, and to try to cut back on the library and education is, it's just the wrong way to go. There's things you ought to provide, and the library is one of them.
I understand.
And now maybe we can, you know, if we can work with the library and everybody can tighten their belt. So I'd have to ask, have they done what they needed? Because I look at all these part-time, and like I said, I'm in there twice a week. So I go in there and I see. But if we had some additional, I don't know if it's 5,000, 10,000, 50, you know, something else we could put toward there. Because these are people that need to use the library. They can't get it anywhere else.
I understand, and I'll certainly take that up with Vicki, but I'll have an answer for you as soon as we determine the digest, which will be next month, and you know where we are with numbers. If that'll give us any additional funds from the general fund, then I'll be able to tell that pretty closely.
And I don't know that, I know we haven't increased it in the last 2 years, and I see our a new commissioner sitting back there. I'll call him out now. Maybe he can look on the county, because I don't know that they've increased. Well, let's face it, all costs have gone up. And if you don't increase over two or three or however many years it is, well, you're just gonna get lower service, I mean, or fewer hours or something.
I agree, and I think it's fair. If I have conversations with Vicki again, we're not part of that management, but when I look at some of the operational items, I'd have to question a couple things just the same. And you know, if everyone is redefining their operations today, budget-wise, and obviously everyone is strapped and the costs keep going up, but for in order for me to give you a good answer, I have a conversation with her, but then also work with what we have, given the digest and our availability.
Well, we've been through some painful cutbacks ourselves.
But the school system is also contributing, correct?
They have offered, and I'm going to let the branch manager take that up with the Board of Ed.
Okay.
Pete, let me ask you this. It says on here that they're using some reserve money this year. How did they get the reserve money? Where did that come from?
Well, it's interesting you say that, because they've been balancing this budget for the past 6-7 years with the reserves. And I don't know what the reserves is. There was extra money that the library got for when the renovations were due, if I remember correctly.
Okay.
So realistically, this deficit has been going on for 6 or 7 years now, and they've been pulling from the reserves. This is the first year that we've heard about it.
And my understanding is when they did the renovations, probably about, I want to say 8 to 10 years ago, they had money left over they've been using every year to balance the budget since then.
Can I ask you a question? How does the foundation board work with the library board?
Yeah, I'm president of the foundation board. What we do is we raise money for the library. Mm-hmm. We don't pay for salaries or anything, but we pay for programming.
Okay.
Children's programming in the summer, the foundation pays for. We help contribute to the Big Green Bus that's
right
out there. Mm-hmm. We've done some things like that. But the library board is the one that actually oversees the library itself.
Where I'm trying to find that on this budget. Is that on this particular budget that we've got? If you could leave that copy of it there. And these are all questions I know you'll ask of Vicki, but I just, while we have Frank here as the foundation, it's on this page, Frank, on these, it's a separate, it's right there on that second page. See that gem clip?
Oh.
Right there.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Let me ask you this, Pete.
Does programming show up on here?
Your conversations with the library manager, how much would she need
coming in or going out
to make?
I can't even answer that. She's balancing this budget with $57,000.
So she's 57,000.
But she's thinking, but he never said she's going to have to cut back hours.
That would be at 47 hours.
Yeah, and cutting back hours, and still not open on Sunday, which
okay, well, what
There's just a lot of unanswered, and I don't really don't have any influence on that. And there's some answers that before I commit to you, we have got to establish. And the county's, you know, obviously going to ask the same questions,
sure,
that we have to understand that.
Now, the library line item is in our budget, which we are to approve or not approve tonight. So I guess what we would need to do is, if it's approved, it would go in at that 143,715, with the understanding that you and Jim Carter would work with Vicki on maybe analyzing her budget and helping with that. Is that a fair statement to say? Could y'all be okay with that?
It does not.
Yeah,
the budget doesn't have a five in it. It's the one. It's the
138.
It doesn't have,
yes,
that five.
Oh, their budget line item.
But we could come back.
I misread that.
We could come back.
Yeah, $5,000 is not concerning. I'm okay with that.
Okay.
Just because we approved this doesn't mean,
right, we can't analyze it.
We come back and say we're going to give you an extra $50,000.
And that's my question. Are y'all comfortable doing
overboard
that? Let's go ahead and,
yeah,
approve the entire budget, understanding that we'll come back and look, have them look closely at the library and see what we can do.
Yeah. But Mayor and Council, just on the bigger picture, I want to start by saying that, you know, the goal set by you this particular year projected us forward. I think it was a great year with regards to budgets. We made some hard decisions. We looked at a lot of areas, but I can tell you the document before you, the community, and you should be proud, it's balanced. We did that without service increase, obviously without tax increase, so that it's a really great testimony to what we're doing within operations. All departments are stable. Fire department is going to be fully staffed. PD is on their way to be fully staffed. From capital items, from SPLOS to pay to equipment for the departments, we are in really good shape with this particular budget. It also shows your commitment to the employees. This does include a 3% raise for all employees. We have the economic development position that you saw as a goal, which is going to be very, very important for us. Funding of the full Main Street. With our service delivery, we have to take over 100% of funding for that. That is in this budget. Again, I mentioned the capital and SPLOS, but paving and our priority project list, we are doing that with the intensity, and Jeff and his team, ESG, are helping us with that. I mentioned the digest and the numbers. That'll be before you in July, where you make your decisions on what you want to do. Our numbers are up within the city of Tipton, which is a great sign. I just can't give you exacts. Just now. Lastly, community development is going to be coming online. That was environmental management, and this department is going to be moving into the old fire station at the Bass plant. That is going to be a big plus for our service delivery to the community and to our business community. So we're real excited about that, but I could tell you that I'm real proud of the staff and all the department heads on how they're handling the budget. I'm proud of them, and I know you are, but this document is really, really a great testimony of what's going on in the city of Tipton and how we're doing business. But this is the beginning of where we're headed. So thank you, and I certainly appreciate your support.
Pete, I want to commend you on this SRO is with the schools. You know, last year we went through all this, and the school board was contributing 50%. And we pushed, and you pushed them, you know, because every taxpayer throughout the county should help to provide safety for the children in the schools. I mean, it's a school-wide issue. It's a county-wide issue. And Board of Education stepped up and said, okay, we're gonna provide the safety for them. So, but without your pushing, I don't know anything.
Okay, thank you. All right, we have our budget before us, and we've discussed everything on the budget, so I will take a motion to either approve or not approve the FYI 2019 budget.
I move to approve it.
Thank you. Is there a second?
I second.
All right. Any further discussion?
I do have a discussion on the economic development aspect of it. I know we had a little bit of conversation to that. I had some questions about it. I don't know if really answered them or whatnot, but the structure of that organization, is that individual going to be over Main Street or not?
The decision hasn't been made, and that's going to be a future work session discussion for us, because there's a lot to it. And obviously we want to compliment what the chamber's doing. We don't want to duplicate anything. We do not want to, you know, make wrong decisions. So once I have that on paper, then I'm going to bring it forward. We'll have a good discussion about it. But there is no rush to do this. Again, this was your goal. We made it happen, and now comes the details, and that'll be next.
And that's fine. That's great. And what I'm thinking is if we work it out where there is some extra savings, we could possibly also look at helping the library a little bit more with that money and that budget item. For instance, if the structure that we talk about, the way I'm thinking it, I would like to see it go, I think there could be some savings in that department where we could probably apply that to the library if we wanted to, and still have the economic development person on staff. But we're going to talk about that, so I'm okay. As long as we've got these numbers, we can always change them to fluctuate or whatnot. But you know, I'm glad we're going to have some additional discussion about it.
And lastly, I still have to present you the data. We meet Wednesday, the Solid Waste Committee, to talk about Golden Environmental and where we are with solid waste. Richard is wanting to go up a dollar per home, so in the committee we'll talk about that. But I left everything the same in the budget. And to your point, we could, you know, we could obviously take out, adjust whatever we needed, and we'll have to do that in a couple of areas. But it's revenue neutral to us. But I have to have something to work with.
Okay. All right, so we have a motion and a second. We've had lots of discussion. Is there any more discussion? All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? All right, next item is our board report. Okay. Nobody looks handsome. All right, Jessica, do you have any updated items for us for our board report?
There are some terms that have expired or are expiring this month. The ones on the right are the new ones that I received. The ones on the left I have emailed. I have sent these in a snail mail. So if y'all want me to mark them off and y'all don't want to see them again, that's fine with me. I just wanted y'all to get.
You said the ones on the left you've contacted and have had no response from. Mm-hmm. Let's go ahead and take those off. Are y'all okay just taking those off? Because they've been on this list for quite some
ones,
time.
Which ones we take
the
off?
Items, the names, scroll down to the next, the ones on the left there. The ones in blue are the ones that on the right side of that page, on page 110 of your packet, are the ones that she's had communication with and are current and up to date and have signed off on the fact that the information that they have is accurate and all of that we've asked to be included.
On the left, or wrong?
Left.
Left has had no response.
Right's okay.
Okay. I don't have mine. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Right's okay.
Okay. So what I'm asking is I would recommend that we take all of those on the left side of the page off this list so we can clean up our list because some of these have been on there for a year or more.
Left
and
side, right?
Yes.
Left side, okay.
Left side. Mm-hmm. Y'all okay with that? I don't need a motion to that effect.
No,
okay,
no,
Jessica,
no,
if you'll just take those. We'll set those aside. We've got plenty of folks who are willing to serve and are communicating with us. All right. I know we tabled some of these from our last meeting. We do have several that are seeking reappointment. Have they filled out a new application if they're seeking reappointment, or do they need to? I guess they would just update their data and sign off.
We don't make them.
Okay.
I just contact them.
Okay.
Now, Ms. Schoenhauer and Mr. Homer Day did.
Okay.
I'm
going to hold off on that until we have our housing authority tour, say.
But the others, I just called or sent an email.
So what, now you say you're going to hold off on that?
I would like to hold off on appointing to the housing authority. We're trying to plan I'd like for Councilman Terrell and myself and our city manager to visit all of the housing authority properties to review those with some of the board members and the executive director. So I don't want to place anybody on the housing authority at this moment. My understanding is that if they're not reappointed, they continue to serve month to month until either reappointed or a new person is appointed in their seat. So there's no danger of them being able to conduct their business. So
when do you guys plan on doing that?
We're working on that now. I have to defer.
Trying to schedule some dates now, next three weeks.
I'm just curious. I mean, I think, you know, we need to make, we've been talking about that specific goal for a couple of months now.
I know.
Reappoint or not.
Yeah. So We can go ahead if y'all would like to. We've got on the Tifton Planning and Zoning, we have Peter Crowley that's seeking reappointment. Term expires June 30th, and Julie Lester, who's seeking reappointment, her term expires June 30th as well. And on the Tifton Library Board, Cecil Portal, whose term expires June the 30th. So if you would like, we could certainly go ahead and reappoint those individuals who are seeking reappointment.
Do both two on the planning and zoning, they both live in Tifton?
Yes, they have to.
Does Cecil Portal live in Tifton?
I don't know, because that's an older appointment. He does.
He does.
He does. Older.
Okay. That's not a joint board.
Okay. And then we have, going back up on the list on the tree board, Joe LaForest and Jeannie Rigdon, who have served many, many years, and we appreciate that neither of them wish to be reappointed, but we do have George Valitas, who lives in the city, and Jimmy Felton, who also lives in the city, have asked to be considered for appointment to the tree board.
I know I've asked before, but tell me again exactly what the tree board does, other than look at trees.
I probably can't tell you everything that they do, but they did a study, prepared a study years ago, and we became a tree city. And one of those things, when you become a tree city, you have to have a tree board. And they prepared a study that said these are all the bad trees in Tifton.
They had a tree inventory, basically.
Yeah, tree inventory. And so now when somebody requests or the city requests to cut down a tree, the tree board goes out and inspects and, you know, just have some. And they do tree planting, so when they cut one down, they go back and replant it. They do a tree planting every year. It's part of the Tree City USA.
Gotcha. And they are active.
They're very active. And
they meet every
month.
I'd like to interject because I have dealt with them, and I've got two huge sycamore trees. I had an old oak that died, and they brought and put two beautiful sycamores in there. And what they do is quiet work, but it's very valuable work as far as keeping that greenery in our historic and other parts of the community. I mean, a tree lasts a lifetime and they don't cost much. Yeah.
I move to appoint George Valitas and Jimmy Phelps to the tree board.
Okay.
Second.
Any further discussion?
Aye, please.
All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Okay, do you want to reappoint those that are seeking reappointment, or would
let's hold off on that. Their term doesn't expire yet.
Well, it expires at the end of this month.
Yeah.
Just hold off?
Yeah, I mean, they can still sit throughout the month, yeah.
Okay, all right. All right, any other comments, questions, names, ideas for board report? All right. Pete, do you have city manager report? Have you covered everything?
Yes, ma'am. I only have one item. The paving is completed on all our streets, which is great. Striping is being completed as we speak, just as well. And shoulder work and just the last tidy up on all the street sides will be conducted in the next 2 weeks. We did meet with the contractor, and if you know the portion of 8th Street right by CVS that is just horrendous. Mm-hmm. We did talk to the contractor, and they were able to move in here, and part of this contract that we do have some money is still part of this LMIG that they're going to come in and mill that lane out for us and repave that. So I think it's going to be the extra few bucks is well worth it because we can't fill that anymore. So it's just a bad section of road. So we are essentially complete. It was a good round of monies, and we're excited for the next time around. So.
When is our next time around?
It depends when E.B. Hamilton comes around, because we're dedicated the LMIG monies to that. But okay. New SPLOST starts in January, and we'll be really ramped up to go again.
So we've got our list ready so that as soon as the money's ready, we can get started?
We're going to bring the list around to you again, and we'll sift through just like we have.
Man, let's don't wait till the money's ready, then let's look at the list, and 3 months later, then we'll get around to paving.
I understand. So
Jeff's got the list ready.
We got the list.
So we're going to go into the second rounds of the water and sewer, the master planning. Once Pebble Brook is out to bid, we're going to start moving into the sections that really need some infrastructure improvement. And that's next, and hopefully we're aligned with those streets that need to be paved, and it's working very well, and we're making a lot of progress with that.
Excellent.
That's all I have.
And we will all be in Savannah for Georgia Municipal Association training this weekend, so that'll be a good trip. Anything else that needs to come before the council?
Do you guys have the package for us ready?
We do. I think Morgan has those ready.
Oh, I'm ready. I'm full. Ready again.
So, ask and you shall receive. All right, anything else we need to discuss? All right, if there's not, we are adjourned. Thank you.
Thank you.